In today's lecture, we are going to discuss a very important topic, Szilard-Kamers reaction. So, we know that different types of isotopes of radioactive elements shows different types of nuclear reactions. Out of all those reactions, a very common reaction is our N-gamma reaction. So, the N-gamma reaction possesses a neutron which acts as a projectile, that is the particle which we use for bombarding purpose, and the target is bombarded with the help of neutrons. So during this process, the condition is that the neutrons should be slow, otherwise the neutron would not get captured into the nucleus. So for capturing of neutron inside the target element, we required a slow neutron, and as the bombardment takes place, the isotope having one unit mass higher than the parent element forms. For example, here we have taken example of iodine-127, which is the stable isotope, non-active isotope of iodine. When this is bombarded with the help of neutron, it forms the next isotope, that is iodine-128. So here we have just shown asterisk over this iodine. So this asterisk means the product I-128 is in excited state. So as soon as the excited iodine-128 has been formed, it will undergo emission of excess energy in terms of photons known as gamma photons. So here gamma radiation acts as a ejectile, that's why the reaction is known as N-gamma reaction. Now our next part is derive an expression for energy of the 128 iodine isotope which is formed. This isotope form is named as recoil. So we know that momentum is the product of mass and velocity of an object. So here our projectile is a neutron. So as soon as neutron is bombarded on the iodine-127 isotope, the iodine-128 isotope is being formed. So here there are two momentums, we can say. The first, the momentum of recoil atom which is formed, that is iodine-128, and the gamma radiation which is ejected, momentum of that gamma photon. And according to law of conservation of momentum, the momentum of this recoil atom must be equal to momentum of photon, that is gamma photon, which is released. Therefore we can write momentum of recoil atom is equal to momentum of gamma photon. So mathematically we can write m into v is equals to E gamma upon C, that is this equation number 1, where M and V are the masses and velocity of recoil atom, that is the iodine-128 isotope which is formed. Here E gamma represents energy of gamma photon which is emitted during N gamma reaction, and C, which is the velocity of gamma photon, which is nearly same as that of velocity of light in air medium, that is 3×10⁸ meter per second. So from equation 1, now we have to find the value of ER, that is the energy of recoil atom. So now once the recoil atom is being formed, it possesses the only energy called as kinetic energy. Therefore the kinetic energy of that recoil atom is given as, so according to classical physics, ER is equals to 1/2 mv², which is given as equation number 2. Now this kinetic energy equation, that is equation 2, can be modified in the following way. So here we have written that ER is equal to m² v² upon 2m. So what we have done is we have multiplied at numerator by mass and divided by denominator by mass. That is, mathematically we have done same thing on numerator and denominator, that is, it is correct according to mathematics. Therefore we get final equation, that is mv bracket square upon 2m, which is given as equation 3. Now equation 1 can be modified as, so here we have taken equation 1, that is mv is equals to e gamma upon c. Now we have squared both the sides, therefore we get m square v square is equal to e gamma square upon c square. So from equation 3, that is this equation, and 4, that is this equation, we can just write the equation er is equals to e gamma square upon 2m c square, where if you put the value of c and convert the energy in million electron volt, that is MeV, we will get this equation, that is E gamma is equals to 536 into, sorry, ER is equals to 536 into E gamma square divided by M, which is given as equation number 6. So here one thing is important to note, that the mass small m is in unified mass, that is atomic mass unit. So from this above equation number 6, we can say that as for most of the cases, E gamma is in the order of 1 to 5 million electron volt. Therefore for a medium mass nuclei, that is whose mass ranges from 50 to 100 atomic mass unit, we can say that the ER, that is energy of recoil atom, varies about 5 to 250 MeV. So as this energy, that is 250 MeV, is much higher than what the energy possessed by an atom when it is bonded in its compound, that is only it possesses 5 electron volt energy, and now as it is formed in the form of recoil atom, it has possessed nearly 250 MeV energy. So this energy of recoil atom is much higher than what it possesses in its compound. Therefore the bond can be easily broken with the help of this energy, and we get a free reactive recoil atom. So the reason for reactivity of recoil atom is the very high energy possessed by it, shown above. So due to high reactivity of recoil atom, it causes various interaction with species present around it. Species such as free radical, fragments, impurities, solvent can be affected by these recoil atoms as they possess much high energy. Now as we have seen that how N gamma reaction takes place and how they converts a nucleus into the radioactive isotope having one unit mass more than the parent one. So here now the next point is a separation of this radioisotope form in N gamma reaction. So Szilard and Kammer have noted that when an ethyl iodide is bombarded with the help of slow neutrons in presence of water. So here we have taken the two different phases, that is one is water and other one is organic phase, that is ethyl alcohol. So when this ethyl alcohol is bombarded with the slow neutrons, then we get the formation of iodine-128 recoil. So this iodine-128 recoil, most of it passes into iodide ion, 128 I minus ion, in water, and the remaining is get attached or is remains attached to the organic phase, that is carbon. Now one more way to increase the concentration of this 128 I minus in the aqueous phase is to add iodide ion externally, that is in the form of potassium iodide. So here we can add Ki in the water before the bombardment. So this reaction, in which the water contains potassium iodide and the ethyl iodide is bombarded with the help of neutron is commonly known as Szilard-Kamers reaction. So many substances such as the organic compounds like chloro-bromo-iodo compounds and stable complex ions, some oxy-ions, then organometallics such as arsenic, triphenyl, bismuth triphenyl, lead tetraphenyl, stannous tetraphenyl, some ferrocyanides, cobalt and platinum amino acid amino complexes. So such compounds can be studied by using this Szilard-Kamers reaction. So in next lecture we will study this point, that is radiochemical principles in the use of tracers. Thank you.